All right, folks, so today we're going to be on the Xbox Series S, and today we're going to walk through the process of setting up developer mode. Now, as I mentioned, I'm going to be doing this on the Xbox Series S, but this will also work for the Xbox Series X and also on the Xbox One. So the first thing you need to do is head over to the Microsoft Partner Center, and what we're going to need to do is sign up for the developer program. So scroll down the screen until you see Windows and Xbox, and click on Get Started. Then on the next page, click Sign Up Now. Now on the registration page, all you're going to do is select your country or region from the dropdown, and then you're going to select the account type that you want to sign up for, and you'll probably want the individual account, so all you need to do is check the radio button right here. And just so you're aware, there is a one-time $19 cost to this. So next, you're just going to scroll down and fill out all this contact information here. And then once you're done with that, Microsoft's just going to verify you are who you say you are. So it'll sign you into your Microsoft account. Once you're signed in, it will take you to the registration and payment page. Just click on Add New Payment Method. Click on the Add New Payment Method right here. And then just select the payment method that you want to use. Pretty straightforward. Once you're done with that, it'll take you to the app developer agreement. And then all you need to do is check the checkbox to say that you've accepted the terms and conditions. Once you've done that, just click the finish button and it will confirm your registration. Then just click go to dashboard. And your registration's complete. So next, what we need to do is head over to the Xbox. So here we are on the main Xbox dashboard, and we're gonna need to go into the Xbox App Store. And then once we're in there, we're just gonna click on search. And we're gonna do a quick search for dev mode. All right, so you can see at the top there, as you type in, a couple of different apps have appeared. And there's actually two different apps for dev mode. The green one with the picture of the Xbox Series in is the one we're going to take. But if you're using this on the Xbox One, you'll want to take the dev mode activation app with the black icon. So all you do is just click on the app that you need. And you'll get the standard congratulations screen for your purchase. And then we can just back out to the main Xbox menu. All right, so here we are back on the main menu, and you can see there that the app is installing. And then once that's done, what we need to do is just click on that to launch it. And when you do that, you'll come to this screen. This is the Activate Console Welcome screen. So we just click Next. Next again, and it's going to give us an activation code. So what we're going to do is head back over to the PC and back to the Partner Center where we were before. We're going to click the settings icon up in the top right hand corner, select account settings, and then on the next screen, we're going to click Dev Devices over on the left. In the dropdown, we're going to click Xbox One Developer Consoles. And it will bring up the Manage Xbox Devices screen right here. So next, we're going to add our console by pressing the plus icon. And then we're going to select Enter Activation Code. And then in the enter activation code box, we're just going to enter the code that's on the screen on your Xbox. And hit submit. And once you've done that, you'll see that your Xbox is now listed on the devices screen. And then pretty much instantaneously, you should see a change on your Xbox. So we're going to head back over there real quick. And as you can see, the screen has now changed to activating. And then once that's done, you'll see an option to switch to developer mode. So all you need to do is click switch and restart. And your console will shut down and reboot into developer mode. Now this takes a little bit of time, but you'll see the Xbox boot animation as you normally would in retail mode. And then once that's done, you'll be on the Xbox developer dashboard. So now we've got dev mode up and running, there are a couple of settings that we're going to change. First, we're going to click down to get to settings. And then we're going to head over to the right to the launch settings option. And that'll bring up your general settings. So the first thing you want to do is head into your network settings just to make sure that your internet's all set up. Now I'm on a wired network, so I don't need to change anything here, but if you need to set up a wireless network, obviously you just click set up wireless network. Once you've got your network set up, just click back to go back to the general settings page. And then we're going to head into the power mode and startup options. And then we're going to click right to the power mode. And just make sure that this is set to instant on. Now, the reason that we're making this change is to avoid running into a little bit of a bug. If you have your system set to energy savings, like I did when I first set this up, when you go to turn it off or put it in sleep mode, the console will just continually power cycle. So you can never actually turn your Xbox off. So if that does happen to you, this is how you fix it. Okay, so now we're done with the power mode settings. We're just going to click back and head back to the main dev mode menu. And we're going to set up our remote access. Now, what remote access will allow you to do is access all of your files on your Xbox remotely through your PC. So this just makes transferring files over to your Xbox a whole bunch easier. So to do that, we select remote access settings down in the bottom right hand corner. And double check that the enable Xbox device portal checkbox is checked. You're also going to want to make note of the two web addresses right here. And we'll use those in a few minutes on the computer. Then we're going to scroll down to authentication and set username and password. And then obviously you would just set a username and password. This is for accessing your Xbox remotely. Once you're done with that, click save. And then just scroll down and select close. And then finally, we're just going to adjust the amount of storage space allocated to dev mode on your internal SSD. So to do that, on your controller, hit the menu button. Then in the sidebar menu that pops up, select Manage Dev Storage. And then in the Manage Dev Storage Space screen, you'll see a slide bar which allows you to manage the amount of storage space allocated to developer mode. It starts off at 5 GB, and in my case, because I'm on an Xbox Series S, goes up to 337.5 GB. Now, I'm going to be using my system predominantly for emulation, so I want as much space assigned to developer mode as possible. If you're planning on switching between dev mode and retail mode, then you'll want to try and even it up just so you have space for your retail games as well. So all you need to do to allocate the space is just hit right to increase the storage space allocation. Once you've got the allocation that you want, you just need to press down and select save. And once you press save, it will restart your console. Basically what it's doing here is just reallocating the space, creating a partition for developer mode on your SSD. Okay, so now your Xbox is rebooted. We're actually done on here for a minute, but we are going to head over to the PC once again, just to get everything set up for remote sharing. So we'll head back there. And the first thing you want to do is open up a new browser, and you just want to enter one of the two web addresses which we saw on the Xbox earlier. So when you do that, it's going to open a new web page, and there's a good chance that you'll see this connection isn't private warning. Now, I would ordinarily be a bit cautious on this. However, we know this is safe. So all we need to do is click the Advanced button. And then click Continue to Xbox right underneath that. Once you click that, it's going to ask you to sign into the site. Now, this is the username and password which you set up just a couple of minutes ago over on the Xbox in the remote access settings. So just type that in real quick and hit sign in. And then we're in the Xbox device portal. So next on the menu on the left, we're going to go to File Explorer. And we're going to click Browse up in the top right corner. And this will bring up the file path, username and password for your Xbox system. Now, I'm not a huge fan of having to add credentials every time I try and access a folder. And thankfully, Microsoft's thought of that and has been kind enough to set up a command prompt for us so we don't have to. So in order to activate that, we're going to copy this string of text here. And then we're going to open command prompt. And you can do that by clicking the search button and just typing in command prompt and it should pop up. Then once you've got command prompt up and running, all you need to do is paste the text and hit enter. And then you'll see that credentials have been added successfully. So basically what that means is every time we try and access the Xbox files in File Explorer on the PC, we don't have to plug in our credentials, which is great. Okay, so now we're done with that. We're actually going to map this location as a drive on our PC. So what that means is, again, when you're in File Explorer, you'll see all of your standard internal drives. But then at the bottom of that, as long as your Xbox is turned on and connected to the network, you should see your Xbox files and folders actually mapped as a drive location. Again, just makes it easier to access going forward. So to map the drive, all we need to do is open a File Explorer window. And then in the address bar, just type in the file location. And there you'll see the folders that are on the Xbox, so we can confirm that that location works. Next, we're going to click on the Easy Access button. And then in the drop down, we're going to click Map a Drive. We're going to select a drive letter. So in this instance, we're going to select X. And then we're going to type in the Xbox folder location one more time. And we're just going to hit Finish. Then once that's done, you can check to make sure that the network drive mapping worked by clicking on this PC. And as you can see at the bottom of the list here, there are our Xbox files mapped as drive X. So that'll make things a lot easier when we come to start transferring files over. So essentially now your Xbox is set up in developer mode. The last thing I wanted to run through real quick is if you wanted to switch your Xbox back into retail mode. So we'll head back over to the Xbox real quick and we'll look at the process for that. So back on the main Xbox developer menu, if you want to switch back into retail mode, all you need to do is head over to leave dev mode and select that. And once you've clicked on that, you'll see leave dev mode pop up. But before you click OK, just make sure that the checkbox right next to delete sideloaded games and apps is unchecked. You want to turn that off. Essentially, if you have that checked and you have been installing stuff onto your Xbox, if you leave that checkbox checked, it's going to delete everything that you have put onto the Xbox yourself. So just double check that. Once that's unchecked, you can click OK and your Xbox will reboot into retail mode. And then obviously, if you want to get back into developer mode, all you need to do is click on the dev mode app, just as we did originally, and your console will reboot back into developer mode. Pretty straightforward. All right, so that's how you set up dev mode on an Xbox Series S, X, or Xbox One. There's obviously a ton of stuff we can do now with dev mode, and we'll definitely be taking a look at that in some future videos. So be sure to stop back and check those out. I hope you found the video helpful. If you have, please drop us a like and also consider subscribing. It's really helping the channel grow. And also, don't forget to check us out on Twitter. Thanks for watching.